Hello children, good morning. So today I am going to start a new chapter in civics, that is chapter number 4, Features of a Democratic Government. In this chapter, we should know about what is apartheid. So children, have you heard about Nelson Mandela? He is the Nelson Mandela. Did you know that he spent 27 years in prison to fight apartheid, which means apartness in Africans? He liberated his country, South Africa, from the racial discrimination. But children, what is apartheid? So what is apartheid? Apartheid means separation on the basis of race. South African people were divided into white, black, Indian and colored races. According to the law, these races were not allowed to mingle with each other, to live near each other, or even to use common facilities. So children, in South Africa, the majority black population was under the rule of white people. The Europeans in power came up with the system of apartheid, a system of racial segregation, so that they could control the economic and social systems of the country. This policy of racial segregation denied the non-European groups of any rights and privileges. So they could not vote, they could not own land, they could not travel in the same compartment in the trains with the Europeans, and also they could not even go to the same restaurants or hotels where the Europeans frequented. They needed to carry identification papers and were often denied employment to certain offices. So this practice, which started in the beginning of the 19th century, rose to its height between 1948 and 1994. So Nelson Mandela and a wing of African National Congress started a movement against apartheid in the early 1960s. In 1962, Nelson Mandela was arrested for being involved in this movement. Apartheid was practiced till the 1990s and was formally abolished when the country's first multiracial elections were held on 27th April 1994. So Nelson Mandela was elected the first non-European president of South Africa on 10th May 1994. So in 1994, South Africa became a democratic country where people of all races were considered equally. So Nelson Mandela was the president of South Africa for 1994 to 1999, and he was awarded Nobel Peace Prize in 1993. So children, South Africa became a democratic country. So now, what is democratic country? What is democratic government? A democratic government is a government which is elected by the people of the country. It symbolizes the rule of the people, as the government derives its authority and legitimacy from the people. There are many forms of democratic government, and however, there are certain basic features that are common to all democratic government. They are participation. The policy of apartheid in South Africa prevented non-Europeans from participating in the day-to-day working of the country. So participation ensures that people are aware of their decision and their rights. Participation happens in the following ways, like right to vote. Right to vote is utmost importance in a representative democracy. All adults of a country should have the right to vote in elections and select their representatives. They also have the right to re-elect the same representative or elect another representative if they are not satisfied with their previous choice. The right to opinion, in this, people also have the right to express their views freely if they are not comfortable with any decision taken by the government. People generally express their concern by going to the media, newspapers, television, internet, radio, which in turn voices the concerns of the people. They often take things in their own hands too, and they organize rallies, dharnas, and fast to attract the attention of the government. Every time there is a hike in the price of petrol, people voice their concern. Similarly, whenever rates of essential commodities are increased, people have voiced their concerns and managed to bring down the prices. In spite of the various channels available for raising concerns, not all of our demands are fulfilled. But it does remind the government that it is accountable for the people of the country. So children, this is all about today's class. Thank you.